it. And we have different examples just to give to the one of the 2020 strategy, which had set great social objectives, but then in parallel, austerity measures were decided, and we know that objectives haven't been met for that reason. Other examples, when it comes to recommendations made at EU level to member states, asking on the one hand to prioritize areas such as education, for instance, and at the same time asking for cuts in public expenditure. So how do we reconcile this? This is about making political choices, and this is what politics are about. But for this, we need clear vision, clear goals, adequate resource to support them.
Are we able to actually match demand and supply at the moment? What would happen if we stopped doing what we were doing? If all the volunteers that we have actually stopped doing what they were doing for one day, what would it look like?
One thing that we have seen during this pandemic is the spread of virtual volunteering. This is not new, but this is something that has came to stay after the COVID and the social distance. Volunteer organizations should be prepared to take advantage from this kind of social mobilization, because this volunteering is virtual, but volunteers are so real, that people who want to help others and want to change the world. So we should take care of these new volunteers, but it's not always easy.
For that, we've also noticed a lot of many different issues, simply because of the way that regulators, but also employers, view digitalization. So even a simple thing as working from home has been not permitted at all by many employers, up until the point and at which governments have started to saying, well, no, now it's a rule, you have to work from home, we're shutting down businesses. I know many people in my social circles who have been forced to work from their offices, not because they had to perform an essential service, but simply because employers wouldn't trust them to do their work at home. And similarly, we have a problem with many legislations being not tech neutral. And what that means is basically that you have legislation that assumes that analog processes and procedures are the norm, and thus digital technologies that actually could be used or are being used are interfered with because they cannot be.
These contributions are really very fragmented. Okay, we have still this tendencies to act in this very sectorial way. And we really, I think that now, if the civil society is a democratic actor, and if we have something, some alternative vision to produce and to propose, we should really draft the overall picture of the changes that we want to have.
I think it's very, very important, this question around high intensity volunteering with emotional impacts. We see that also in other parts of Europe, for example, volunteers coming forward after floods in Central and Eastern Europe, numbers of volunteers coming forward to work with refugees who are trying to travel through various parts of Europe, for example, in Serbia, in Greece, who are coming forward and who are doing things very, very well and with very good intention, but in a way that's not necessarily physically or emotionally sustainable.
We should not really lose this moment, because COVID, it's like the big analyzer of our society. And I really agree that the inequalities are the most pressure problem between the population, but also between the society. If we look on the European level, and when I spoke about Europe, it's not only EU, but also Eastern Partnership countries, we see also the inequalities between the society in Europe. And when we spoke about volunteering, I think also that the societies are not equal. If you look on Moldova, for example, where the countries have really the struggle to build the vibrant society and vibrant civil society. So my question and ideas and proposal is also focus on some countries where the volunteering has some difficulties to be the relevant forces for change. because the financial crisis that and a lot of countries already say that there is the economical recession. So how the financial crisis that we follow COVID pandemic will surely impact civil society sector, but how we can build the solidarity between the grassroots organization, because a lot of them will just stop work, yeah, and they will disappear. So so I think that it is in our interest to maintain them and to help them to exist and to be operational, because they intervene in different part of the public policy. They are really the important actors to draw this overall picture of the transformation that we need. And clear, we need the transformation. We spoke about capitalism. I would like to just make the link with what Harper said about capitalism. And maybe I feel very interesting the contribution of the new UN rapporteur on poverty, Olivier de Schutter, who speak about ecological and economical transition in a more systemic way. Yeah, so maybe we should also speak about the transition, the climate is also one, and so ecological and economical transition together, and the volunteer sector is really the important actor to have the look on that and to propose the new ideas.
I think that's a great moment to leave with. Don't let's lose the moment. I think that was your final message, and I think that's a great point to finish our debate on today.